Hi, this is Ram from Crossmind Studio. Welcome back to another chapter from Liquid Simulation series. And today we are going to talk about the particles which are available within the liquid domain, which you can use for generating foam particles, bubbles, and spray. So if you have like a waves simulation or maybe a kind of a drink where on top of it you need some foam layer, a separate layer, so you can use these particles, and that's what we're going to talk about. So I'll keep this video as short as possible and give you a breakdown of the scene that you've seen in the preview. So I have this very basic scene set up in front of me. There are very few objects like this glass, which I made using the Bezier curve. So if I isolate this one, you can see I'm using the screw modifier on the glass. I'm pretty sure you're familiar with this process already. So this glass is there, and then we have a very small piece of bottle which is just enough to fill in the frame, and then there is this plane over here which we need to emit the liquid. Alright, so let's select this plane over here and go to the object and quick effect, quick liquid. So we get the domain. Now let's go to the edit mode and extend this domain so that we cover all the area wherever we need the fluid simulation to happen. All right, so this much is enough. Let's go to the frame one and see if we can see any particles. So at this point there are no particles. That's because this plane over here is a planar and it doesn't have any volume. So when we don't have the volume on the surface, there should be some surface emission. So this way, yeah, some particles fall out of it, but instead of the geometry, we need the inflow, the continuous behavior in the particles. All right, so that's a good start. But instead of fluid falling down from here, we want this to flow from here. And for that to happen, we need collision enabled on this one. So let's apply a collision effector on this one and see what happens. I think we need to give it some sort of surface thickness and maybe increase the resolution a bit. And now you can see the particles are falling from here instead. Yeah, so one more thing, we need to enable a collision on this one as well so that it can contain the liquid. So let's apply a effector and let's give some surface thickness to this one as well. 0.1 maybe, and I'll change the display type into bumps so that we can see the particles. Let's do one quick bake. So as you can see over here, now the particles are taking shape of the glass, and that means our glass is kind of working. The collision is working, but there is not enough surface thickness. So let's increase the surface thickness to, sorry, maybe, yeah, 0.5 is fine. So let's test it out. So yeah, I think this looks fine. The collision is working, and few particles which are leaking from here and there, I guess that problem will go away once we increase the resolution to 128. So right now the liquid is kind of pouring continuously, and we don't want that. We need this simulation, I mean this plane, emission plane, to emit particles for just around 40 frames. So on the frame 46, I'll enable a key. I'll set a key and go to the 47, disable the use flow, and again key this one already over here. And yeah, and also the speed of the simulation, I'm kind of looking for a slow motion shot. For that, I'm going to decrease the time scale to 0.6, 0.5, whatever suits your taste. So I'm just going to do another quick bake and see what's going on over here. So yeah, here's the simulation, and right now the only problem which I see over here is the fluid is pouring kind of at a very small, very slow rate, and that's not really looking great. Instead, I want this fluid to come at with a bit more velocity so that it can touch the other side of the glass over here, like from here till here. something like that. Over here, you can see after frame 46, emitter stops emitting the plane. That's because of these keys over here that we have set up just now. Select the emission plane and enable the initial velocity and maybe give it some velocity into the normal direction, because the normals are set into this direction. So just don't forget to check the direction of the normal and fix it before working on this. All right. So let's do a preview again. So as you can see now, with the velocity enabled, the shape is kind of interesting. So from here, it collides with the outer wall and takes the U shape, and this flow looks much better than previous one, which where fluid was straight going down. So I think, yeah, the more or less the setup is there. We just need to see how this looks with the higher resolution. So I'll just increase the settings to 128. And on this one, I'll change the sampling substeps to 2, just in case, because there is a slight motion, and even though it's not a high speed moving object, it's always good to have some sampling substeps into moving objects. So let's do a preview. I'll set this to modular, is resumable, and bake the data. Yeah. So I have around 80 frames baked already, and this looks fine. I think we are good to go ahead and bake the entire simulation. The only thing I would like to add into this one is increase the initial velocity into the normal direction, because over here you can see it's still not making the perfect U shape that we saw earlier in the preview. So because we increased the resolution, the behavior of the simulation kind of changes depending on the resolution. So I'll have to increase the velocity a bit, I guess. Select the domain and so let's bake the entire simulation and come back with the results. All right, so I have the final cache over here, and this looks pretty good. The only problem I see over here is I've kind of forgot to enable the border collisions. The particles that fall out of the glass are colliding with the borders and are collected over here, so we don't want to see that. So for this, just disable all these border collision settings. Now I think we are good to go ahead and bake the mesh for it and then work on the particles over here. So I'll just free the cache and disable the particle the border collisions. I'll bake this one and then bake the cache and come back with the results. All right, so the bake is done, and we have around 200-300 frames. Now we have the particles, we have the mesh, and now only thing we need is the foam on top of this simulation. So first thing I'm going to do is this mesh over here looks quite noisy. So let's apply one smooth modifier on this one. Smooth factor by around 2, maybe repeat by 5. I'll leave it to 4 for now. I'm not quite sure if you can fix this problem that is there in the mesh. I can't really get a smooth looking mesh with the collision geometry. So maybe you'll have to either work with really high resolution like 256 or something. So let me know if you guys have a solution for this one. So if I render this out now, I'll give you material breakdown later. It's a very basic material, and there's nothing I think we need to discuss, but I'll still give you a material breakdown later. So this is what it looks like right now. Now let's go to the domain properties. We have the main liquid simulation baked. Let's minimize this one. Then we have the mesh over here. Now only thing we need is the particles. So if you go to the particle over here, we have only liquid particles over here. So once you enable any of the particles within the liquid domain, and that will show up over here as well. So let's enable the foam and disable the render. So let's enable the foam and bake the particles. And you can just play around with these different kind and whether you want all the three or just the foam. So depending on what kind of simulation you're dealing with, so if it's a water simulation like a water tank, or if it's the wave ocean or something, then you might would need much more than just the foam. So for now, I think this is the only thing I'm going to deal with, and let's bake the particles. I'll just skip the video ahead and come back with the results. All right, so we have the particles for the foam over here, and if I disable the mesh now, you can see there is an additional layer of particles. So let's go to the particle setting and disable the liquid particles. So these particles are the foam, which is a separate layer. And if I play the animation, you can see this layer, it rests on top of the liquid, the rest of the liquid. So it's just a thin layer on top of everything and resting there like a foam. And you can control a lot about it, and I haven't quite played with all these settings a lot, but I guess there is a lot you can control about it. Yeah, and now we have the particles, and the only thing we need to do is give these particles geometry that needs to be rendered. So let's enable our liquid particles again. Yeah, so we have the main liquid and the foam particles on the top. And keep in mind, once we change these particles to the geometry, and then the scene kind of gets very heavy. So you need to keep in mind, like if you select the foam particles over here, you can see there are so many number of particles, like almost like a million particles over here. So if once we change this to object and assign I have this icosphere over here, which I'm going to use as the particle over here. So if I assign this shape and instance this on the particles, so try to keep as this particle instance particle as low as possible in the geometry, otherwise your scene kind of gets crazy heavy. Okay, so all those particles are now solid, and if I enable the render, let's see what's going on in the render. As you can see over here, my scene is quite heavy right now, and it takes quite some time to buffer things, and so you need to be a bit patient with this once the foam particles are enabled. And I would suggest that you disable the particles in the viewport and use the render preview instead of viewport shading. So I'll just go to the particle settings over here. Select this one and just disable the foam in the viewport. And this way we have much more responsive viewport. So I'll just go to the camera view and render one a very small preview so that we can compare both the results, one with the foam and one without the foam. Alright, so here I have both the examples. On the this one is with the foam, and this over here is without the foam. And as you can see over here, these edges look pretty hard and there is no transition going on, and both are different treatments. So if you're like rendering like a beer or something, or any kind of fluid, where any kind of drink where there are bubbles of foam, then this kind, the I mean without the particles, it looks pretty hard. I mean, there is no transition or the softness going on around the edges. And with the foam, you can see there is a nice transition in the color, and all those particles of the foam which are sitting on top of the drink create a nice transition and give the overall simulation a much softer look. And this is not the finest example. I'm sure if you play more with this, very interesting results can be achieved with this. And this is just an experimental, a very quick attempt with the foam particles. So let's talk about the material breakdown now. All right, so let's talk about the material and the render setup. So for this, I'm obviously using the cycles render, as you must have seen during the tutorial. And for the glass shader, there is a very standard glass BSDF, and in the volume, I added the volume absorption just to add some sort of a tint in the glass. So I don't think the tint is working. That's because the faces are not completely closed. So you can just ignore that. So yeah, I'll just delete this one. So that is one thing. And then there is a very basic glass shader on this one as well. And for the main domain, I mean the main fluid, we have a glass in the surface and volume absorption in the volume. So this is what giving it the tint that you see. And in the environment, so in the environment I have two HDRI. One is the interior.exr, which comes with the Blender in the default folder, and one is the night.exr, and these two I'm using in the multiply node, and that's what you see over here. So if I just mute these nodes, you can see this one is the interior.exr, and this one is the night.exr. And once I use the both and enable the multiply nodes, just to balance out the combination of the both HDRI, I used this multiply node. So, and in the camera, I have a depth of field enabled. I think I'll have to enable this over here. Yeah, so this point helper, empty helper, is helping with the depth of field. And for the last thing, the foam particle, I've used, it's a bit of a cheating. It's just that, so there's a very basic standard principled BSDF, and in this one, I've given some emission. So there is a transmission going on, which is giving it the transparency. So on top of that, I used emission, and the reason behind that is I just wanted the foam layer to stand out a bit. And once I enable the foam layer, you can see it's going to get slower. That's why I didn't want it to enable in the viewport. So I'll just enable this one and enable the render and just pause the video for a bit. All right, so here's the render with the foam. And if I disable this emission value, then you can see the foam. And once I disable the emission, then you can see these particles were not standing out. So try to create contrasting materials. So like transparent into transparent won't work for the foam particles. Any like translucent kind of shader, or maybe even the solid particles would work for this. So that's it for today. And if you guys want to study this file further, you can download this file from my Gumroad account. The link is in the description. And I would love to see what you guys create with this one. And I hope you guys enjoyed today's chapter, and I look forward to see you in my next tutorial, which is about the explosion. And we will be doing that session on the 26th of this month. So don't forget to tag me in your post at InstaCrossMind on Instagram. I'll see you guys in the next chapter. Stay tuned, subscribe, and give it a thumbs up if you like the tutorial. Take care. I'll see you guys in the next chapter.